And this strapping young lad must be Cedric, am I right?
Sir.
Cedric Diggory was a good, kind and brave person that everyone would remember his name. His death may just be one of the series' biggest tragedies. It affected Harry, Cho Chang and everybody else. Cedric was a very popular student at Hogwarts, extremely skilled at Quidditch, and above all that, always loyal and fair to his friends, and to everyone in general. So in today's video, we'll be discussing Cedric's entire life, where he was born, his years at Hogwarts, and his adventure throughout the Triwizard tournament that led to his sadly death. Cedric Diggory was born in September 1977 to Amos Diggory and his wife. He grew up near Street Catchpole, a small town located in England. They lived not too far from both the Weasleys' barrow and the Lovegoods' house. Cedric was a tall and extremely handsome young man with dark hair and bright grey eyes. His father Amos was extremely proud of his son and his achievements, always bragging about him. Cedric attended Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry on 1st September 1989 and was sorted into Hufflepuff House. Soon after starting Hogwarts, Cedric became a popular student at the school and people talked about him constantly. And because of his handsomeness, Cedric caught attention from numerous girls. Cedric was excellent as both an academic and athletic student. At some point, he became secret of his house Quidditch team. In 1993, Cedric became a prefect and a captain of the Hufflepuff Quidditch team. He led his team against Gryffindor in the first match of the school year. During the match, Cedric and Harry Potter contested the Golden Snitch. However, Harry was overcome by the presence of the Dementors and fell from his broom. Cedric caught the Golden Snitch, but as soon as he realized what had happened to Harry, he immediately offered to replay the match. Oliver Wood was said to have declined the offer, feeling that Cedric had won the match fair. When Harry got back his fire-bolt broomstick, Cedric was among those who congratulated Harry on his ownership of the broomstick. In the summer of 1994, Cedric attended the Quidditch World Cup with his father, traveling to the game with the Weasleys, Harry and Hermione, as he and his father lived close to the barrow, which I mentioned earlier. Amos, who enjoys bragging about Cedric, was as follows. I said, Cedric, there'll be something to tell your grandchildren, that you beat Harry Potter. Cedric looked slightly embarrassed. Harry fell off his broom, Dad. I told you, it was an accident. Yes, but we didn't fall off, did you? Cedric started his 6th year at Hogwarts, the same year that the Triwizard tournament was held. Being of age, Cedric submitted his name to the Goblet of Fire for the chance to become the Hogwarts champion. On 31 October, the Goblet chose the champions to represent the three schools, Victor Crumb for Durmstrang, Fleur Delacour for Beauxbatons, and Cedric himself for Hogwarts. Cedric joined the other champions in a small room off the Great Hall and was surprised to learn that after he had left the hall, the Goblet had produced a fourth name, Harry Potter. Cedric later asked Harry how he managed to cheat. Harry claimed that he didn't cheat and put his name in, and while no one thought he was telling the truth, Cedric was kind to Harry. Enchanted badges became popular around the school that read support Cedric Diggory, the real Hogwarts champion, then changed to read Potter Stinks. Cedric, however, was not happy about the badges and asked his friends not to wear them.
Hey, listen, about the badges, I've asked them not to wear them.
Don't worry about it.
As part of the tournament, Cedric took part in the wand weighing ceremony conducted by Garrick Ollivander, who tested his wand and he posed for photos for the Daily Prophet. In the months before the first task, Cedric was informed by Harry that the first task was to get past the dragon. Cedric was the only champion not to be aware of them, and Harry felt it was only fair to tell him so everyone would be equal. On 24 November, the champions gathered and randomly selected a different version of dragons. Cedric drew the Swedish short snout. He entered the area first to attempt to retrieve the golden egg it was guarding. Cedric transfigured a rock into a dog to destruct the creature. While the dragon turned to chase the dog, Cedric went for the golden egg. The dragon, however, burnt Cedric on the side of his face and he barely managed to get away from it. He was sent to Madame Pomfrey in the hospital wing. Like all the champions, Cedric had to work out the clue hidden in the golden egg to prepare for the second task. He was helped by Party Crouch Jr., disguised as Alastair Moody, who told him to take it into the bath and listen to it underwater. He took it to the prefect's bathroom on the 5th floor, opened the egg underwater. He heard the clue, but it took him a while to figure out. At Christmas, Cedric was required to attend the Yellow Ball, a tradition part of the Triwizard tournament. He asked Cho Chang to attend the ball with him, and she accepted. In fact, Fleur Delacour tried to charm him into becoming her date for the Yellow Ball. He refused, however, and claimed that he already had a date. It could be said that Cedric was a man of his word, with remarkable inner strength. Cedric started dating Cho Chang when he asked her to be his partner for the Yellow Ball, and the two continued dating throughout the year. Towards the end of the ball, Cedric found Harry and told him to take the egg into the bath, and worked out the clue as he had done. It was a repayment for warning him about the dragons. He also gave Harry access to the prefect's bathroom. On 24 February, the second test took place. Having deciphered the clue in the golden egg, Cedric knew he had to breathe underwater for at least an hour and retrieve something that had been stolen from him. He used the bubble head charm and reached the mer people Violet shortly after Harry. He found that his something that would be taken from him was true, and he did rescue her. He arrived 1 minute outside the hour time limit and received 47 points. After two tasks, he was tied for first place with Harry. Before the third task, Cedric along with other champions joined Lord Bagman to view the maze that was being grown on the Hogwarts Quidditch pitch. Cedric was dismayed to see the Quidditch pitch overgrown, but was assured by Bagman that the pitch would be returned to normal following the end of the tournament. In the third test, Cedric was joined by his parents, who had been invited to watch their son. Because they were tied for first place, Cedric entered the maze with Harry. They split up, each hoping to be the first to get the Triwizard Cup placed in the center of the maze. Soon after, Cedric came across Victor Crumb. Crumb, who was under the Imperius Curse at the time, attacked Cedric with the Cruciatus Curse. He was saved by Harry, who stunned Crumb and permanently shot red sparks into the air to mark Crumb's position so Victor could be retrieved from the maze. Despite being briefly united, he and Harry split apart again to seek the cup. Cedric spotted the cup and he ran towards it as fast as he could. From his left, an Acromantura burst into the path and attacked him. His wand was knocked out of his hand, but he was saved by Harry again. Harry and Cedric then both stunned the spider at the same time. The two of them found themselves next to the Triwizard Cup. Having been saved by Harry twice in the maze, Cedric asked him to take the cup. They both took hold of it. Their touch activated the cup, which was a porky, and the two of them were transported to Little Hangleton graveyard. Soon after their arrival, Peter Pettigrew emerged from the darkness, carrying the small form of Lord Voldemort. Voldemort ordered Pettigrew to kill Cedric, and he used Voldemort's own wand to murder Cedric. He was dead. Cedric still had a role to play in the night's events. After Voldemort was reborn, he and Harry engaged in a duel, creating a backward spell effect. Cedric's shadow emerged from Voldemort's wand and asked Harry to take his body back to his parents. Harry agreed, and when he broke the wand connection, he took hold of Cedric's body, then summoned the cup to himself. Cedric's body was returned to Hogwarts grounds, and Harry clung to it, refusing to let it go. The crowd that had gathered erupted into screams when they realized what had happened, and Cedric's parents were devastated by the fate that had been befalling their son. Cedric's death also hit Cho Chang so hard, and she cried a lot over him. After Cedric's death, Amos was overcome his sadness. Along with his wife, they visited Harry in the hospital wing and thanked him for bringing his son's body back, and assured Harry that he wasn't to blame for his son's death. Cedric's death was widely filmed throughout the school. The leaving feast was turned into a memorial for him, with black banners replacing the house colors. Dumbledore delivered a tribute to Cedric and relayed the events that had led to his death. Cedric proved to be an inspiration to many students at Hogwarts. His death was heartfelt and was tragic enough to cause even those who disliked Harry to believe his claims of Voldemort's return. In the next year, during the Dumbledore's army meetings, Cedric was a key point of interest, with students wanting to know a lot about how he died. Cedric's death had a deep effect on Harry. Despite losing his parents as a baby, this was the first proper time someone he truly knew died in front of him as a direct result of a decision he made. This was the death that gave Harry the ability to see distros, and the death that haunted his dream for a time afterwards.
Don't kill Cedric! Who's Cedric? Your boyfriend?
Harry killing Voldemort at the end of the Battle of Hogwarts were also an event for Cedric Diggory. Harry continued to honor him by keeping a badge that says "Support Cedric Diggory." Cedric's death was a really terrible loss. He was exceptionally hardworking, fair-minded, and most importantly, a loyal person. but it would be unfair to only remember Cedric for his shocking death scene when he made so much more impacts than that.